pleased to present, right, as Ann said, transforming your information security team with a managed security solution. I would like to start off actually and get a show of hands from the group here, just to kind of get a baseline of who I'll be speaking to today. Does anyone here come from an MSP themselves? No? What about from a government entity? So that must mean the remainder would be from the private sector, perhaps. Yeah? Excellent. Great, thank you. Just like to know who I'm presenting to so I can really cater and meet your expectations. I'm sure you've seen this slide a few times this week. I do have to show it to you again, but basically it means everything I'm presenting to you today is my own opinion. So let me start off with the current state of the industry, where really only a few or very well-funded companies can afford that dedicated team of security experts who are really ready to defend against the latest and greatest threats to your environment. Most companies these days, right, are time and resource limited as it is, and really don't have the ability to staff up a complete SOC or even form a basic security team, right? Let's be honest with ourselves. And at the same time, other companies are, of course, still dealing with a talent shortage, where it's just become very difficult to find quality talent at a reasonable price, and even harder to retain that talent when there are so many other opportunities out there, right? And even some of the largest companies in the world turn to a managed security provider to help formulate effective information security. With a managed security provider, there is no upfront cost and investment in staff, and the security experts that you're gonna have available to you on tap would typically have 10 plus years or more, right, of experience that they can provide as an extension to your team. So now I'm gonna talk about the vetting process of choosing a managed security provider. And we'll discuss the 6 steps here that you should take to successfully choose an MSP who will offer the guidance and support needed to achieve your goals. Managed security providers can help lower your overhead so you don't need to spend a fortune on that excellent crew of information security experts. And MSPs can also help deliver better scalability right to your growing organization. So let's hop right in and discuss these 6 steps to vet a managed security provider. First, you must know the needs of your organization. That is critical. If you're planning to hire or use a managed security provider, it's important to know what you want to get out of the relationship. And you're going to hear that word a lot today. Are you planning on solving an existing security challenge, or perhaps just augment your existing team of security experts? Knowing what you want to get out, again, of the relationship will help guide your conversations and qualifiers. And don't get distracted, please. Concentrate on the security gaps that you can identify and focus on the solutions that are essential to solving those challenges. When investigating a potential managed security provider, you really want to strike the right balance between all the fancy bells and whistles and the essential features. You really want to concentrate on what's needed to grow your particular, or to solve, excuse me, your particular security challenges. Essential features should always outweigh really anything else. If you go with a provider with the fancy features, you will likely realize that they have lower quality core features, and you may end up regretting that. And next, you definitely want to account for service proficiencies. Your company will need to know that the managed security provider will be able to actually achieve, right, your defined objectives reliably and successfully. You want to be narrowing down contenders by reviewing their capabilities. Look for managed security providers who are of high quality, who innovate, who have great customer service, and really have enough, I'll say, buying power to provide the resources however and wherever they are required. You don't want to find out after the fact and after spending a lot of money that the managed security provider that you've signed up for can only deliver on a portion of your requirements, right? And you really should be seeking that superior expertise, that superior talent for the security needs of your company, right? That just makes sense. A good managed security provider should have a team of many dedicated, industry-recognized experts on tap for your company to work with. And you may find that once you start looking, that one managed security provider might just check all the boxes. However, if that's the case, I still highly recommend that you follow through with the rest of these steps to complete the vetting process. Again, you don't want to regret spending money on a security provider that can only deliver on a portion of those requirements. Ask the MSP, the managed security provider, to actually show you the features or functions that you need working in a production environment. If they say it's on the roadmap, think twice. This is a very important one. You're going to want to compare deliverables and service options. There truly is no one-size-fits-all security model. Each and every organization is going to be different. They're going to be different in size. They're going to be in different industries, in different geographical locations, right? And it all matters because the delivery service needs to, well, cater to what those differences bring. There is no one-size-fits-all. The small law firm in middle America is going to have drastically different requirements and expectations than that global manufacturer, right? And while it's important for you to know what your organization does well, it's also imperative that you understand what your limitations are. If you can articulate those limitations to your managed security provider, it's going to be fairly easy to match the deliverables and options that they are offering to you, right? And you really should be looking for a provider that works for you and augments their delivery model to satisfy your unique requirements and challenges. Our service serves over 200 clients, and I have to say that each and every one of them are drastically different. There's something unique about them that we have to keep in mind, and we have to augment our delivery model to satisfy those requirements. Let's look at a few examples. This is a very simplified example, but here we've got customer A, who is a fairly large client with over 50,000 employees. And they already had in-house resources to deploy and manage information security products. And they simply wanted to augment their team with a few skilled data or triage analysts, right? Alert fatigue is definitely a thing. And because they're a large client, they face a large amount of data that gets generated by their users and just needed assistance triaging those incidents. So they only needed the I'll put it in quotes, low package, right? Here's an example of customer B, a smaller customer with a bare bones IT team of just a few people, and they smartly chose to go with a higher tier service to take advantage of the additional hand-holding and consulting they would receive in the process. And finally, customer C, a medium-sized employee, I'd say, with about 3,000 employees. But they are, you know, a manufacturer of proprietary products. And they're getting the most premium, white glove service that the managed security provider is offering. They have a lot of sensitive data, a lot of intellectual property that they need protected, and they're in need of constant due diligence and daily conversations with the service provider to assist with that incident response in real time. They also have a perpetual Zoom meeting set up and are in constant communication with that provider. So just to kind of summarize this in a simplified way, the smaller customer is never required to take the basic package, and a giant organization isn't required to take the most top tier or premium package either. It's best to get what's actually going to fit and realistically function best for your organization and its needs. Again, a plan that works for one customer may not for another. And I'll say it again, this is a simplified example, but it's nice when an MSP offers options and you can match those options with your requirements, right? This one holds a special place in my heart. Part of the vetting process is really determining how the managed security provider demonstrates to your company, to your organization, how your overall security posture has improved over the duration of the project, right? Are you able to take the reports and deliverables and metrics that they're providing you and interpret them? Can they be used to educate executive management and justify the spend? Every company is going to have KPIs, key performance indicators, but you are going to need a way to actually measure those data points, interpret those data points, and effectively articulate that to your management, right? The data provided by the managed security provider. And if reports are automated, just make sure they're not going into some void or black hole, right, to get discarded or ignored. It is important for us too, as one who provides a service, that you do find value in the service we're providing, right? So make sure there's a way to gain insight and interpret the information that we're providing to you. Being able to visualize information is absolutely paramount to use as an aid to articulating the value of the service. Really, if you don't understand the data you're looking at, it's not worth anything, right? And just like any critical purchase, influence is important. Word of mouth is incredibly powerful, and you can vet references provided by a managed security provider. Ask each provider you're looking for a list of references. It would be best if they're similar in size, with similar requirements, and if possible, maybe in the same industry, right? And these references should provide you with firsthand accounting into the experience, the actual experience that they've had with the managed security provider. Look for obvious red flags, sure, but also use this as a learning environment. Learn what that customer did successfully with the managed security provider. What worked well, what didn't work well, right? Use their information to bolster your strategy. And don't rush this process, please. Really, ask a list of references. They should be able to provide them to you, and you should have conversations with those references. And don't hold back, please. Now, my question presented to you here is rhetorical. It's often extremely difficult to apply a financial figure to sensitive data, to your company's data, even though that intellectual property or sensitive data might be critical to your business. It's very difficult to quantify. It's difficult to quantify the impact losing those critical assets would have on your organization. And cheap services are often low in quality. Sure, you get what you pay for. And I would really hate to hear after today that someone here went with the lowest bidder and ended up regretting that decision. We've had a lot of customers come to us without having fully vetted an MSP who ultimately failed to deliver on their requirements. And they come to us looking for a better experience, right? The vetting process is extremely important. So let me switch gears here a little bit and show you some quick stats I found from IBM. This and a few of these here are from last year, 2020 to 2021. And we can see that the average cost of a data breach has increased by 10%. That can amount to hundreds of thousands, if not millions of dollars, right, depending on the severity and size. And we absolutely expect this number to rise. And we can see here that when remote work was a factor, the average cost of a data breach increased by over $1 million. And remote work is just becoming more and more accepted, as we have seen over the past year or two. The per cost of a single record of PII is $180 per record. Again, this can add up to a large sum if you don't have cyber insurance, and it can be absolutely devastating, especially to smaller firms. And we saw from 2020 to 2021, the average cost of a ransomware breach reached just over $4.6 million. And this is an average breach, right? One that would possibly get remediated before spreading to the entire environment, or perhaps the data was backed up and was ultimately recoverable. And yeah, of course, you need a good disaster recovery program for this to work well. But companies that face a full ransomware compromise can see the cost of remediation reach much higher amounts than this. Remember, this is just an average. And finally, I come to possibly the most concerning statistic here. We only see fully deployed security on roughly 25% of organizations. That's scary. This tells me that the remainder, 75% of organizations, will face higher costs than what I've just laid out. So now that I've outlined the do's and don'ts of choosing a managed security provider, I want to share the next steps in the process, how to begin a successful deployment. So let me introduce you to the three essential steps for success. I've worked with literal hundreds of clients over the past decade, and this is truly what I think makes or breaks a successful engagement. Let me outline the steps for you here at a high level, and then we can dive in. First and foremost, you must understand what data is critical to your environment and what needs to be protected. Without this knowledge, it can be very difficult for the managed security provider to effectively implement control. When you create a relationship with the managed security provider, you will absolutely increase the camaraderie, and it is really one of the most essential steps for a successful engagement. So let me actually ask the audience here for a second. Who here has ever worked for a vendor that just didn't communicate well, right? It happens all the time. And it really often just doesn't work out as well as you'd hoped, and you have to look for a new vendor, right? Well, that happens on our side as well, right? Having that relationship and that communication is key to success. And continuing there, well, continuously communicate. And like I said, that ties into step two, but it's more considering the long-term, right? The long-term relationship and the effects it would have. And now I'm happy to dive into each of these separately. So first, know your security requirements, right? First, you'll need to identify the data that needs to be protected. And these are the items that should be critical, absolutely critical to the success of your business. And it can often be difficult to determine what's critical or what is sensitive. And typically there are tools and activities that an MSP can offer that can help you with that, right? We call that data discovery. It's basically a piece of technology or software that would go through your environment and naturally discover all of your data and tell you where your sensitive data is, where it resides, who's touching it, where is it moving to, right? Is it all located within a certain central repository? Maybe it's in SharePoint, or maybe it's strewn about several servers or endpoints, right? It's extremely imperative that you fully understand where your data is and what data absolutely needs to be protected. If a data breach occurs, or a data loss is currently occurring, it is important that your managed security provider knows what is sensitive in your environment so they can go and keep control, keep eyes on it, or confirm that the data has not been affected, right, by a breach. Whether proactive or reactive, this is a very important step in the process. And the managed security provider might also want to put controls, right, around that data to prevent it from being interacted with improperly or being exfiltrated. A top-tier managed security provider would typically start with a data discovery and risk assessment engagement to satisfy these requirements. And they do that for every customer coming on board, right? A very important part of the process. Creating a relationship. So please try and create a functional relationship, right? It's a very powerful word, relationship. I'm not talking about your traditional vendor-client interactions. I'm not talking about a partnership. I'm talking about a real relationship, right? And of course, the more interaction you're gonna have with your managed security provider, the better that relationship will be. And it's a two-way street, and communication is important. Your managed security provider should intimately know your data, your users, and how your users interact with that data, and how they use your internal technologies and systems. Without that intimate knowledge and without a functional relationship, the managed security provider really will just honestly be doing the bare minimum and probably won't be as effective as they could be. Discussing expectations up front is also extremely important. You need to understand what your provider will be doing day in and day out on a daily basis. And the provider needs to understand what you expect from them, right? So they can properly and successfully deliver on it. You know what assuming means, right? Try treating the managed security provider and their team as an actual extension of your security team. Think of them as a third arm. And of course, keeping an open dialogue between yourself and the provider will only help the relationship mature. Continuously communicate. So you really can't expect the managed security provider to automatically assume what you want, right? Or the changes that you need made to improve your security posture. We can provide guidance, but the overall security governance really needs to come from the client. Conducting regular quarterly business reviews with the managed security provider to discuss trends, incidents, or policy changes, among other things, can really help flesh out the improvements that need to be taken into consideration short term. And reoccurring meetings on an even shorter cadence can really provide the ability to have good collaboration between your security team and the managed security provider. We've got weekly meetings with all of our clients. And this collaboration is a function of the managed security provider being an extension of your security team. Without constant communication with the MSP, the standards and criterion will absolutely decline. And like I said earlier, unfortunately, the bare minimum will probably start to be done. The client that speaks up once a month asking for random things and then goes silent, well, unfortunately, those don't fare very well. Communication is key to a successful engagement. So remember, know your security requirements, locate and understand the data that is critical and needs to be protected, create a relationship with the managed security provider, and continue to continuously communicate. You do these three things, and I guarantee you'll have a successful engagement with a managed security provider. All right, so if you are considering using a managed security provider, here are some ways to apply what we've discussed today. Next week, you should be able to identify your security needs and are at least able to start considering which solutions are must-haves to fill those gaps. Right? The subsequent 3 months after that, you should be close to choosing your top contenders, or the top contenders, based on competency and their proficiencies, and really only focus on services that fill your security gaps that you had identified earlier. And during the 6 months following, or preferably shorter, you've been reviewing and vetting the references from the MSP vendors you're interested in. And please, like I said before, it's imperative that there's a way to gain insight from the information that the MSP will be providing to you. If you don't understand the data you're looking at, it's not worth anything. And that's it for me today, guys. I'll open it up to any questions if there are any.
Hello. I hope you can hear me. I have a question. You talked that you as an MSP have 200 customers and that you customize, let's say, that they're all different.
Yes.
So, like, how do you see that scaling as an MSSP or MSP? Like, do you just keep this as a knowledge base, or like does it scale less, like in the sense that you offer the same solutions to your customers and you just like have like known differences that each customer has, or like, or do you just hire dedicated people to service, let's say, like these different kind of customers?
Yeah. I mean, talking about our service specifically, we've got some prepackaged high-level outlines that we'll deliver to clients. But once they're working with one of our analysts, who's a dedicated named resource on the account, again, they're going to create a real relationship with the client. They're going to understand their wants, needs, and requirements, and cater the delivery, the recommendations we're making, right, the discussions we're having, will all be based around that specific client's needs.
Okay, thank you.
Yep. Any other questions? No? Okay.
Thanks.
Thank you.